Ciao guys!
Ciao guys!
And welcome back to Lempi. As you can see, I'm finally reunited with Bubuccino.
We are actually in London. We finally met here after a month that we didn't see each other because that is our anniversary weekend and we decided to spend it in London.
Yes!
This is also some friends because we also have friends here. So.
In this video, we wanted to talk about, really to share with you the truth about a long distance relationship, everything, the pain, the cheating,
the cheating.
Jealousy.
Have you been cheating me? Cheating on me?
We are going to talk about that. I think it's good that we talk about that. Doing the long distance relationship thing, mm-hmm. We have done that before, but now we're doing it as married couple.
Yes. So how do you manage a distance relationship when you are married?
The first thing that comes to my mind, especially, let me put it this way, Monday to Friday are okay on both sides.
I'm very busy
Monday to Friday. Problem is Friday afternoon. I don't work on Friday afternoons.
Mm-hmm.
And when it's Friday afternoon and it's time to go home, I'm like, what do I do? Okay, I go to the gym, then I'm done with the gym, then now what? My partner is not there, my best friend is not there, we can't go to our favorite place and drink something or eat something. So, and then those are problematic.
I mean, for me it's a little bit different because my situation is I'm not living by myself. I'm not like in an apartment and when I go home after work, I just find the apartment empty.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I come back from work in Italy, I always have my family. My mother is busy in the kitchen preparing some dinner for me. My father probably is watching TV. My sister is also there and I don't know, my sister, she's always doing her stuff in her room. I rarely go out of it, but I know that she's there and of course that also prevents me. I think I don't feel alone as much as Lempi does.
It's just that I don't have a kid, I don't have a dog. I don't have any person there than in the apartment. It's just me, a Lempi for Lempi. And even if I want to cook something exciting, for example, it's like I cook something just for me and it's not exciting to eat anymore at the end of the day.
Mm-hmm.
Beside that, of course, in distance relationship, you want to stay connected.
Okay.
You call each other a lot, but I hate that. I hate talking to you on the phone when you're in Rome.
Yes, because
connection is bad.
Apart from the connection, but one thing is like when I'm not busy, but if I'm in the middle of something, I cannot really stay like for 20 or 30 minutes and listen to her because I also have to do some work. So I always like put them like on loudspeakers on background and I'm doing something.
Everything
so
in the kitchen.
Sometimes she get really,
like,
really pissed.
Do you have
because,
time to talk to me now?
Yes. Do you have time to talk to me? Yes, baby. I have time. But in the meantime, I'm writing emails.
I'm making pasta. I'm feeding the dogs and all things. So I feel emotionally disconnected when you're away because I think you're not together physically, but also emotionally you're not really together. So the thing is, when whatever I'm doing, maybe I'm watching a romantic movie, then I'm really missing you and I call you.
Mm-hmm.
You were probably outside playing with the dogs. Or mm-hmm. when I call you, like, oh, I'm in the middle of something, call me later. I'm like, you're rejecting me. I honestly feel like that.
Okay.
I'm like, okay, I'm like...
Wait, because you are putting me on a bad spotlight.
No,
but it's
but
not like that.
It's the same for me.
Like,
I
always
have
a. No, it's not true. You're not saying the truth. I'm sorry. I have to, like, I put my feet down now at the moment.
Uh-huh.
I give you the card, I put my feet down. And I say that, first of all, I'm, like, always available
that
on the phone. Like, almost every single time that she's called me, I answer the phone. On the second at the rings or the third ring maximum, I'm always like responding to the phone. And another thing is, you're not calling me like one or two times per day. You are calling me probably, I would say, from 8 in the morning. You're probably
every
in
time
the
when I want to call somebody, I'm probably calling you.
Yes.
Or every time I want to talk to somebody, because now you're the person that I live with. I also don't have family around mm-hmm. here. Mm-hmm. Another thing that I also always feel like when you're in a distance relationship, as much as you want to talk to each other as often as possible, there's also almost there's no topic that is appropriate to talk about.
What do you mean?
I become very, very sensitive to every single thing you say to me on the phone.
Ah, that is true. Because, you know, when you talk on the phone, there is a missing part in the conversation, which is your face. So, and she's also not the faster one in picking up, like, irony and this kind of jokes. And when I try
to joke to me,
when I say something like that is a little bit I don't know, I would say like not provoking, like she's always taking it like, oh my goodness, what are you saying, why are you doing that? So yeah, I was joking, just chill,
but I also don't like to talk about something very emotional. Like I never want to call you talking about I miss you very much, da, 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 because that makes me feel like I'm going to cry, I'm going to be very sad and miserable, so I avoid that.
Yes, I also think you are avoiding that because you don't want to be weak.
Yes, so I really don't like to talk about it. So most of the time when I call you, even though I miss you and I really want to express that, I would rather just be talking about YouTube. But you don't like that. You like Lampi is like you only call
me. You call me for work. Like you are calling me for work. You either
you miss me or you miss working together.
I don't know. I just feel sometimes I feel like you are missing just because you need to talk like about your day with somebody, and I understand that, but to a certain limit. And then also because the other conversation is YouTube.
Yeah,
how do we do
the
YouTube?
Let me communicate this to you.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time when I talk about YouTube, I really miss you. That's why I call you. But I never want to talk so much about emotion, because when if I tap into the emotion side of me,
mm-hmm.
then I'm very emotional. Then after the call, I'm just crying all night. Now, cheating.
Cheating. So
does
did you cheat?
No. No.
Did you cheat?
No.
Are you sure you didn't cheat?
No. I haven't cheated. But it's not about, for me, cheating, of course, I think when you're in a distance relationship, cheating does come to your mind. But the reason I don't cheat
mm-hmm.
has nothing to do with you.
Yeah,
has nothing to do with you. I mean, I've dated people that have cheated on me before, but I never
me
cheated.
Too.
It's not about you. It's about myself as a person. I just feel I'm disrespecting myself.
Yes, and that I think also that is the main difference, and that is something that we have in common. One of the few things that we have in common,
probably
actually.
Probably the only thing.
Cheating is not about I'm not cheating somebody because I love them or because of what I prove for them. It's about your mental state and your own persona. I cannot be like in the same bed as you are, knowing that I'm being cheating on you. It's just not my. It's not part of my persona.
For me, I think if with the moment I decide to cheat, I would rather just say, because I think that's an indication that that's the end of the thing.
Yeah,
we don't have anything anymore. So it's like it's over. I'm moving on.
Yes, definitely.
So I'm not like back and forth. That's not me. What else? So what do you think made the long distance relationship work?
Have discipline. For me, it's also about to have self-discipline and stay positive, like positive mind. For example, as we say, no, the trust, the fact that thinking about yes, you haven't been together for so long, are you not afraid that your partner is cheating on you?
Oh yeah, you
that is it's not me because I cannot be on that page. I cannot be afraid of something that I don't know. Of course, there is the possibility. It's life.
Being afraid
there is always,
doesn't help you.
Yeah, being afraid that doesn't help you doesn't bring anything positive in the relationship. I don't think that if you cheat is something, it's because I did something wrong or.
No.
It's just because you
personal
decided.
Weakness.
Yeah, it's your personal weakness, or you just discovered that maybe I'm not the right partner for you anymore.
A better person.
Even though I really seriously doubt, because I'm so awesome. So.
Okay, good.
Yes, I mean, I'm so charming, I'm cute.
Wow. Yes. CV is good for dating.
No. To find Superman. You need to find Superman. Yeah, come on. So be confident.
It's true. So it's like, no, Limpy isn't cheating.
No, there's no way that she's going to find another guy like me. So,
you give yourself like,
yes,
yeah,
like,
yeah, I know what I put on the table.
Yes, be confident is one of the main reasons why I'm not panicking about the fact that we are in a decent relationship at the moment. True. And. Because I know who I am, I know what is my value, I know what I put on the table, I know the kind of person I am. I have, of course, as anybody else, I have dark side, I have positive side, but I think I'm on the balance, on the scale, I put much more positive than negative.
If you want to risk this...
risk
yeah, this. All this, if you want to risk all this, okay, it's fine, but you know, it's going to be all loose. You're the one going to be losing.
No.
So I put it like that, and just, you know, you have to be confident in what you have and what you put on the table.
Be confident of yourself and who you are, and also just trust in your partner.
Being so jealousy or very afraid won't help you, to just make you miserable instead.
I think
about unnecessary things.
I think that is something that would either took me to the edge of cheating. Like, if I have always like somebody that is jealous on me about
everything I do,
yeah, that they it forces you on the wrong side. No, it's also I don't know, jealousy. I understand jealousy, but really an unlimited amount in the relationship. Now, because of my previous relationship, and I have been with person that were really jealousy. Now I will not stand it anymore. It's something that I cannot stand anymore.
Like, you're being accused of things you haven't done. You all haven't the time. Done.
No, you no. And
things you haven't even thought about.
Not only that, but then I discovered that the person that is jealous is the one that was really cheating. So
anyway, so those are our tips. So how do we keep it? Trust, self-confidence, and just stay connected. Even though connected is difficult because our communication on the phone is not the best.
Yeah, they should.
Guys, that was it from us today. Thank you so much for watching. And don't get irritated if Ali's like, I'm brushing my hair all the time because I haven't had long hair.
Like she
24/7.
When did you mean? Like, not even
yesterday, and it's ruined for me because I'm just like this.
Yeah, not even 24 hours. She has been playing yes.
So guys, if you enjoyed this video, give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and most important, guys, always leave a comment in the description below. That is very, very helpful, and it helps us improve our channel.
Yep.
I would like to hear from you, or Ali would also, we would like to know from you, how do you keep your long, or how do you make long distance relationship work, or would you even consider being in a long distance
relationship?
See you in our next video, and
ciao.
And also, I wanted to know if you enjoy this kind of video and you like us to do more of this relationship talk thing.
Yes.
No, leave that down there. We might find more stuff to talk about.
Yes. Bye bye.